Okay, guys, welcome back for another episode of Saloon Talk. It is another Sunday yet again. If at all you have been having a tough week, your week has been sad, your week has been happy, whatever your week has brought up to you, it is a Sunday and Savara Hughes is in your screen right about now. So make sure you tell a friend, Saloon Talk is on right about now on Urban TV. The show runs from every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. So better make sure. If you know you want a beauty care, whether it's to cut your hair, it's to cut your beard, it's to plait your hair, whatever beauty care you want, Spectra Saloon has it all under taken care of. Whichever branch you decide to go to, they have one in Kabalagala, one in Bugolobi, and then one in Machindye. So guys, if you know you want to do your nails, to do your hair, whatever beauty care you want, they have it right here on the show. And before I introduce my guest, the topic for today is fashion. What is fashion and why fashion as a career? Because fashion has a lot of, it has a lot ingrained in it. There is music part of it. There are fashion models part of it. There are creatives under it. So we're going to be seeing what fashion as a topic itself, what has it done to the people who are in it. Okay, guys, my guest's already in the building. So right about now, without wasting any more time, we're going to get acquainted with them as they tell us their names and what they do. We're going to be talking about the topic right after they introduce themselves. I'm going to start with the beautiful lady herself all the way on my extreme right because they say ladies first. So me, I'm not counted. So guys, beautiful lady in orange. So kovuze kubantu, those people out there who are watching the show right about now, what you do and your beautiful name.
Hi everyone, my name is Nakaenga Janat. I'm a model from Latif Fashions and I basically work with Latif and Company.
Boss, go to get a good letter. Oh, you're having some. You're going to explain to the fans, Mr. Gentleman. How do they greet you? That's an officer. Thank you so much for coming to the show. We're so glad to have you. Amanya bakuitani akulabe ayagala kumanya manya gogani ate okola chi.
Manya marungi nyo bantaja ja Master Kaya, somesa Sakura Tifa Academy, somesa guitar, keyboard, na music.
Guys, I know you're wondering, guitar master, don't worry. He's going to give us a sample of some special song, Latif Agenda Tugambakachi, before he performs it for us. And of course, the man himself, the big man himself, I know you're wondering, what's going on here? First, what do you mean? Before we even introduce the legend himself, what's going on in the shot? I'm seeing Uganda, America, even behind them, even be Germany, right?
Mawanga magati. But anyway, I'm so glad to be on set with Urban TV. And I'm very privileged, you know, to be back on air with you guys, you know, to give the people what they need. My name is Latif Madoy. I'm a fashion designer, a fashion tutor, and also a fashion performer or fashion artist. Call me the Jet Speed Designer, designer wa Mori, atungira kunyonyi. And they refer me to as the Afro Fashion Magician, designer at Unge Bitete Mudachi Kampawe Kaga. Because we know, you know, fashion works hand in hand with music, because music is a big inspiration for fashion. And that's why I work with Jaja Master Kaya. For those who have, you know, watched me perform live, I do what we call a fashion concert. Normally, we perform what we call Makans Pakas production. It's a type of percussions that has fashion in it, which is represented basically with scissors. So Jaja Master Kaya is here to, you know, educate and also introduce our new Uganda national anthem, which is already translated in Uganda. We've already done the three stanzas is our Uganda national anthem, but this time around agenda bayimbira esoka because he needs to be paid, you know. Alyokaba yimbira zili esatu. So Jaja Master Kaya, there for you. That's right.
Oh, Uganda, tondo tubele, tu kwa sebisela bya yomaso. Kwegata mudembe twefuge bulijjo kusimba la la.
That's right.
Wow. I was gonna clap, but it's a Uganda national anthem, so I don't think we're supposed to clap. That was so beautiful. Thank you so much, Jaja. Guys, so the topic today is fashion as a career. We all know fashion is very big, just like the entertainment industry. The entertainment industry comprises of music, movies, whatever, as long as it's something that brings amusement to your eyes, that is what they call entertainment. Same goes about with fashion. Fashion has a lot embroidered in it. We have the creatives that create the fashion we see. We have the models that showcase the outfits that the creatives make, and then we have the artists or the musicians that create the ambience and the vibe whenever, for example, there is whenever a creative is creating, for one, because we always have to have like that source of inspiration, and also when the models are showcasing the pieces for what we call fashion showcases, there is always supposed to be like a good ambience of music. So that is how fashion comes about with so many different factors. We also have the business side of it. Before we even go any further, why fashion? Like, why not boda boda riding? Why not, you know, like a businessman? Of course, being a fashion man, you're a businessman, but I'm talking about those corporate office things. Why fashion?
That's a very good question. Why not boda boda? Why not banking? First of all, you need to discover yourself. Once you discover what you can do best, that's what you have to follow so you can deliver. I chose fashion because since way back when I was still a little kid, and it's what I've been practicing. So for me to master it. And why fashion? It's been my passion, you know.
Okay, I was going to ask this, but you have actually said it. I've realized that Jaja and the beautiful lady herself, they are both from your company, like from your academy. She's from the modeling part of it, and he's teaching. He said he's teaching at the academy itself. So first, tell us more of the academy. Is it more of a fashion thing, or there is a lot more to learn?
The academy, Latif Academy Talent School, we are privileged to be accredited by DIT, Directorate of Industrial Training, which is under the Ministry of Education. And it's an art school. Whatever revolves around art is all about Latif Academy.
Okay, let us first pose the questions on Latif, because I know we have a lot and we are still talking about them. But I want to know, as a model, What are some of those challenges you face, Adam, like as a model? Because obviously, sometimes there are those irrelevant, like relevant issues like city day, or you have not done this. There are some companies, we don't know about Latif, you're going to be telling us more about your company. But there are some agencies you work for, they don't give you food, they don't really cater for it. So it's for you as a model, what are some of those experiences you have faced?
Okay, the most important thing is that I would first of all thank God for granting me this height, because basically if you want to join this like being a model, you must have the size, you know, because most of the times when a person tells you that, you know, that size is too, it's you're really too fat, you cannot fit into the outfit. So at times they tell us that you're not supposed to eat a lot because you will not bring out the dress code or the outfit that the designer wants the outfit to be. So at times you're supposed to limit yourselves onto eating some foodstuffs you get, so in order for you to maintain.
You basically take them on dieting.
Wow, because now we have been, there's always been that satire that a model is supposed to look exactly like this. But now we have had very many different kinds of model brands that have come about when they're showcasing different sizes. But I think that comes when like you assign and they have a specific designer. But if like it's a designer is trying to showcase his work and he's obviously he will have to get someone who fits in his work,
exactly.
Not the other way around.
That's right. And for those who have watched me perform live, I think I create my designs live on stage. And I draw the inspirations from the complexion, the model's size and shape, and this is where I create my designs from. So the size, the complexion, the skin color, and their height basically gives you that kind of inspiration to create. Okay. So she's very right.
All right, okay. Jaja. Music. Music is a very big soul for most people. Abantu bagala nyo omuziki. That's why you find people mabala ngari ku muziki. So what would you say is the perfect genre? Like, what type of music is perfect for a fashion showcase? Like how Latif is on stage creating his design, you know, making the design. What type of music now is Joshua Ogamba? Oh, this is perfect for this perfect scene.
First of all, reggae music. Yeah.
Reggae nga babuli wa mwagwa wana wana. Omanyo abaraste. But anyway.
Reggae. Then neka don't come mulungi nyo. Asobola mulungi nyo okubera nga atambulira wamu ne fashion.
For those who don't know, Kadonkamu is basically country music. But as for us, as Latif, when he's performing, we created what we call Makans Pakas production. Gabo Ulida percussion discussion. But this is a new type of percussions.
Okay.
Yeah, and actually our type of reggae is trying to refer to is called reggae linga. It's more of Afro reggae. Yeah.
Okay.
But it's done with African beats and the rhythms are reggae.
I think I've heard Afro-reggae before. It's a very nice...
This is reggae linga, yeah. Something that you can refer to as Afro-reggae.
Okay, guys, let us first go for a short commercial break. We are still in the topic. If you don't know what the topic is about today, feel free to go down to our social media platform. That is Urban Television Uganda, hashtag Saloon Talk. Make sure you see what we are talking about and maybe leave a comment. One or two, maybe. Let us go make some money. And when we come back, we still have the legend himself.